new substances are formed. So in the first experiment, take a ribbon of magnesium, burn it with a sandpaper, and then put the ribbon of magnesium over a flame of candle. So when it burns, it gives a brilliant white light, and after the burning process completes, it leaves a powdery ash-like structure. So here the reaction can be termed as magnesium, the ribbon of magnesium, Mg, is burned along with the candle flame. The candle flame burns in the presence of oxygen, right? So magnesium plus oxygen burns to give rise to a magnesium oxide, the powdery ash-like structure. So Mg plus O2 has given rise to MgO, that is magnesium oxide. So this is the chemical reaction of this experiment. These chemical reactions are not similar with the mathematical reactions. They are completely different with them. So in further process, after the powdery ash has formed MgO, it has to be mixed with water and stir it with a spoon or something, so that it completely gets mixed up with the water. So collect the powdered ash and mix it with water. Collect the MgO, magnesium oxide, and mix it with water. Then test with the blue and a red litmus paper. You know, litmus paper is an indicator, right? It indicates whether the substance is acidic or basic. So here it indicates that magnesium oxide is a base. Then when you get a basic solution, right? Then dissolve this ash and give. So when this ash is dissolved with water, it has again given rise to a new substance. That reaction can be termed as when this magnesium oxide or the powdered ash which we have got as a result of this experiment has been mixed with water. So MgO, magnesium oxide mixed with water, H2O, has given rise to a new substance called magnesium hydroxide, MgOH2. Then whatever chemical formula which contains OH in its end is always a base. That is a blindly what you can remember. Other than that, you can also test it with a red or a blue litmus paper. Then you will know that it is a base. So magnesium hydroxide is always a base. So result of this experiment, we have got new substances, and those are basic in nature. So this is a chemical change in which new substance was formed along with the new substance. The new type of, along with the new substance, we have got new nature of the substance. So when magnesium oxide, the powdered ash, what we got when we mixed it with water, we received a new substance called magnesium hydroxide, which is a base. Any substance having OH in its formula at the end is always a base. Other than that, you can test the substance with a red or a blue litmus paper, then you can know it is magnesium hydroxide. It is a basic solution. This is a new substance formed. So this is a chemical reaction. Then moving on to experiment number 2. Take 2 beakers, okay? In the first beaker, fill it with dilute sulfuric acid plus water plus copper sulfate solution. Take 2 glass beakers. In the first glass beaker, fill a solution. That's the solution of dilute sulfuric acid. The formula of sulfuric acid is H2SO4. Since now your classes are increasing, you are growing up, whenever you talk of any chemical thing, you have to speak it with its formula. So the formula of dilute sulfuric acid is H2SO4. H is hydrogen, SO4 is sulfur. So dilute H2SO4, dilute sulfuric acid plus water H2O plus copper sulfate CuSO4. So this first beaker, you have to add a mixture of this solution. So the mixture of this solution will give a blue colored solution to you. So take a beaker, add 3 substances, you get a solution, a blue colored solution. In the second beaker, add half of this solution. So this solution only half you have to make. Put it one sample here, one sample here. And in this second solution, you have to add a rusted iron nail or a blade which your fathers used for shaving purpose. In the second beaker, you have taken the half of the solution of this first beaker. The solution is a mixture of dilute sulfuric acid plus water plus copper sulfate. It is blue in color. So the blue solution is put half into the second beaker, and you have added an iron nail or an iron blade to it, and wait for 30 minutes after adding that. After 30 minutes, you see the solution will be turned into greenish in color. Why? Because of the presence of rust on the iron substances. And that blade will turn into brownish in color. Why? Because of the presence of the iron deposit solid. So this reaction can be termed as copper sulfate solution, that is blue colored solution, plus iron has given rise to an iron sulfate solution plus copper. So the solution has turned green in color, right? So that solution has become iron sulfate, that is FeSO4 indicated by, plus the brownish color deposits are copper. So this reaction is again a chemical reaction. The thing has undergone a chemical change. A new substance has been formed. a new color change has also been observed. So copper sulfate solution when mixed with the iron, it has given rise to the iron sulfate plus brown copper, that is brown color deposit, and iron sulfate solution is green. So blue colored solution turned into green color, and also brown color deposits have been seen on the blade. So when you take the blade outside, you can see the brown color deposits. So after doing this experiment, you have to wait for 30 minutes. Then you see the color change of the liquid solution. And when you take the blade outside and keep it, you see the brown color deposits, which are iron sulfate plus copper. These are the two experiments. Now moving on to experiment number 3 for proving chemical change. You have to take two test tubes. In the first test tube, you have to add a solution of vinegar. Vinegar is nothing but acetic acid and baking soda. As you mix vinegar with baking soda, you see small hissing sounds over it. That means some types of bubbles are being formed and some type of gas is being formed. So what you do, you put a passer tube like this from this test tube, or you take another test tube and pass a tube like this, so that the hissing sound produces some type of gas which will be passed to the other test tube. In the other test tube, you take lime water. So the gas produced with the help of vinegar and baking soda has been passed with the help of a tube into the lime water. So the gas which was being passed to the other lime water turned the lime water into milky in color. So what was the gas that evolved in this process? It was carbon dioxide gas. So when you mixed vinegar and baking soda, it underwent some change and produced a carbon dioxide gas. And when this carbon dioxide gas was passed into the lime water, the lime water turned milky in color. The next experiment what we are going to see is rusting of iron. As we know, all the railway bridges, pillars, ships, trucks, everything is made up of iron, and all these undergo a lot of change. Where there is lot of moisture content, there the rusting of iron happens very quickly. Rusting is nothing but a change in the iron, a chemical change that also changes its color and texture. So wherever there is high moisture content in the air, because the rusting happens always in the presence of both water and oxygen. So wherever there is high content of moisture in the air, there you see lot of rusting going on. So the rusting reaction can be termed as iron, that is Fe. Iron is indicated by a chemical formula called Fe plus oxygen O2 plus water together leads to the formation of rust. Rust is nothing but iron oxide. And the chemical formula of iron oxide is Fe2O3. So rust is a chemical change of an iron, occurs in the presence of oxygen and water wherever there is air and moisture content, and occurs on all the things like ships, iron bridges, iron tracks, trucks, everywhere. And whenever it is exposed to all the construction materials are usually made up of iron. Then to prevent rusting, what can we do? We have to apply a coat of a paint or a grease over the substance, over that material, to prevent the rusting. What all, one more thing we can do is, you have to deposit a layer of chromium or zinc or iron over that material. So all these are metals. You have to deposit a layer of materials, either chromium or either zinc or iron, over that substance. So if we deposit that material, then rusting process can be prevented. So the process of depositing a layer of zinc on the iron is known as galvanization. So all the things are usually galvanized, which we use the iron pipes. Sometimes the water supply in our house is through iron pipes only. So how do we prevent these iron pipes? Because the water content will always be there in those iron pipes. Water will be always moving through those pipes. From the tank, it will be supplied to all our home. From the tank, it will be supplied to all the apartments. So when there is continuous water, there are chances of rusting with the iron pipes. So how they can prevent that rusting? By applying a layer of chromium or zinc. So this process of applying a layer of zinc on that iron is known as galvanization. Galvanization is done to prevent the rusting. Then have you thought, how do ships are usually made up of iron? A lot of the ship is made up of iron. Ships are always in the water. 1/4 of the cart is always in contact with the water. So in a period of 1 year, almost they need to replace a fraction of the iron. Because due to the presence of water, the ships get rusted very easily. Ships get rusted very easily due to the presence, so they are always in contact in the water. So every year a fraction of the ship is replaced. That means the iron content of the ship is replaced. It will also cost a lot of money for the replacement of iron, because the iron is very costly metal. So this is about the chemical change. This reaction, this experiment can be termed as vinegar. Vinegar is also known as acetic acid, right? So when mixed with baking soda is known as sodium hydrogen carbonate, the whitish colored powder which we use in our food. when these two are mixed together, they had given rise to the gas called carbon dioxide plus some other substances. And when this carbon dioxide gas was passed into the lime water, that is CO2, and the lime water is indicated by CaOH2, that is calcium hydroxide. So CO2 mixed with CaOH2 has given rise to a new substance called calcium carbonate. That is the chunna, what we apply on the betel leaves of palm, which we eat, or the whitish colored part. That is calcium carbonate, CaCO3 plus water. So this reaction also proved that it is a chemical chain and some new substances have formed, along with the evolvement of the gas and the change in color. We will be learning about something called crystallization. How do you think that salt will be formed? Salt is obtained by the evaporation of seawater. Then when seawater is evaporated, they form small crystals which are not pure. So that is leads to the formation of salt. Sometimes large crystals of the pure substances can also be formed from their solutions. Like from the seawater, small crystals will be formed. Small crystals of the salt will be formed. Same way, large crystals of any pure substance can be formed from their solutions. So this process of forming large crystals of the pure solutions is known as crystallization. Take a beaker, fill it with a solution of water plus dilute sulfuric acid. Then heat it over the flame of a candle. Then when it is heating, slowly start adding copper sulfide powder to it and keep stirring or mixing it continuously. Keep adding the powder until no longer the powder can be added. That means add lots and lots of powder until it no longer the powder will be dissolved into the solution. Take a beaker, add a solution of water plus dilute sulfuric acid. Heat the beaker over a candle, and when the mixture is being heated, add a powder of copper sulfate. When you are adding copper sulfate, continuously stir or mix the solution. Add lots of copper sulfate powder that no longer the powder can dissolve. That much quantity you have to add. Then remove it from the flame. Strain it through a strainer. And after straining it, keep it like that undisturbed for 1 hour at least, or some more time. After some time, you see formation of copper sulfate crystals, blue colored crystals. So it is one more method how crystallization will be proved. So crystallization is a physical change. So this completes the lesson, physical changes and chemical changes.